है ना ना।
We were learning about the classification of acids, and the classification of acids can be done in several ways. Yesterday, I mean in our previous video, we have seen the classification of acids based on the source from which acids were obtained, and we have also studied the classification based on basicity. So we have covered the monobasic acids. Now today we'll learn about the dibasic acids and tribasic acids. What are dibasic acids? So dibasic acids are the acids whose basicity is 2. What is the meaning of basicity 2? That means one molecule of acid gives 2H plus ions, or else H3O plus ions, 2H plus ions, or 2H3O plus ions on complete ionization. What is the meaning of ionization? Ionization means that substance will break into ions, will decompose into ions. If a substance decomposes into ions, then it is said to be ionization. Okay, so during ionization of an acid, we'll get a hydrogen ions, H plus ions. If an acid produces 2H plus ions for every one molecule of that acid, then such acids are said to be dibasic acids. Okay, see, these acids, they undergo ionization in two steps. Okay, in aqueous solutions. Example, take sulfuric acid, H2SO4. So this sulfuric acid, it ionizes to form HSO4 minus plus H plus. So this is one step. This is the first step. So in every step, the acid loses one hydrogen ions. So here, this is the first step where H2SO4, it has lost. Okay. H2SO4, it has lost H plus ion in water. So in the presence of water, so this reaction occurs. Okay, so as it is water, so the H plus ion, it won't exist as H plus ion. It immediately converts into H3O plus ion by joining with water molecule. So hydronium ion. So instead of this one, we have to write this one, because in the presence of water, so it is an aqueous solution of acid. So in aqueous solutions of acids, so acids undergo ionization in two steps. Dibasic acids undergo ionization in two steps. Okay, not monobasic acids. Monobasic acids undergo ionization only in one step. But here these are dibasic acids. This is a dibasic acid and it undergo ionization in two steps. So this is the first step. In first step, so this is the substance formed along with the H plus ion or else along with the H3O plus ion. Next, this one will further undergo ionization. That means HSO4 minus. So in the presence of water, again, this one will further undergo ionization and produces SO4 minus 2 along with H plus ion. So again, H plus ion does not exist independently in water. Immediately it converts into H3O plus. So we can write H3O plus instead of H plus ions. H3O plus. Here also we can write H3O plus. Okay, H3O plus hydronium ion. So like this. So this is the second step. So in this way, this acid, this particular acid loses hydrogens step by step. So as it is having two ionizable hydrogens, that means these two hydrogens can be converted into H plus ions. In such case, so initially it loses one hydrogen in the form of H3O plus, and next it loses one more hydrogen in the form of another H3O plus. So that means it undergo ionization in two steps. Suppose tribasic acids, if I take a tribasic acids, they undergo ionization in three steps. Okay, so like this, these are the points related to dibasic acid. And one more point, it forms two series of salts. Dibasic acids forms two series of salts. It forms two series of salts when reacted with bases. Already we know that when acid react with base it forms salt and water. So already we know, and such reactions are said to be neutralization reactions. So already we have learned in our lower classes. So here in case of dibasic acid, so this dibasic acid, it forms what? As it is an acid, so when reacted with base, it forms two series of salts. How it forms two series of salts? Let us learn. See, here H2SO4 acid, dibasic acid, NaOH is a base. Okay. So what happens? So generally acid will, so here when acid and base reacts, it forms water. How water is formed? So one hydrogen atom from acid and OH from base, they combine. So from acid hydrogen will come, and from base OH will come and form water. Okay, so now what is left over here? So after this one will lose hydrogens. One hydrogen it loses, and it loses OH minus. Actually it contains Na plus OH minus. It contains H plus HSO4 minus, because already we have seen. So H2SO4, it forms HSO4 minus and H plus. So that H plus will react. This H plus will combine with the OH minus and forms water. Now sodium Na plus present in the base will combine with the HSO4 minus present in the acid and forms NaHSO4. So this is salt, this is salt, and this is water. So what happened? See, from this acid there are two hydrogens. So one of the hydrogen is replaced by the metal from the salt. Actually, here there should be hydrogen. If in place of sodium, if hydrogen is present, then it will be the acid. So here one sodium atom is replaced. Sorry, one hydrogen is replaced by metal atom, sodium. So metal atom which is coming from base. So like this. That means here one replaceable hydrogen. An acid salt with one replaceable hydrogen. That means still this salt. If you see this salt, so it can lose one more H plus ion. This salt can lose one H plus ion. Because there are two hydrogen ions in sulfuric acid. One hydrogen ion, it has lost. Okay, it has lost. And instead of that hydrogen ion, sodium ion has come. Now this is a salt. This salt, it can further react with base. Why it can further react with base? Because this particular salt, NaHSO4, it is still having one replaceable hydrogen. This hydrogen can be replaced. So what happens? This particular salt, that means it is still having one replaceable hydrogen. That means it can still act as an acid. This particular salt, it can still act as an acid. Hence this salt is said to be acidic salt. Acidic salt. Okay, so in the first step, what is happening? Acidic salt is formed. Acidic salt is one type of salt. So how many series of salts are formed? So here two series of salts are formed. What are they? So one is acidic salt and the other one. What is the other one? See, look here. This sulfuric acid, in this, if two hydrogens are replaced by two sodium atoms, in case two hydrogens are replaced by two sodium atoms, it forms Na2SO4 and two water molecules, two sodium hydroxides contain two OH groups. So if one molecule of this acid, if it is losing two hydrogens and combined with two sodium hydroxides, what happens? So here two sodiums will come. Instead of two hydrogen atoms, two sodiums will come. And along with two hydrogens and two OHs, they form two water molecules. So now this is a salt and this is water. Salt and water. If you carefully observe, what happened? So it is not having any hydrogens. If a salt is not having any hydrogens in it, that means any replaceable hydrogens. So here, this particular salt is having one replaceable hydrogen. Acidic salt contains acidic salts contains replaceable hydrogens. How can I say this is having replaceable hydrogens? See, if I make this one to react with base, for example, NaHSO4, if I make this one to react with NaOH base, what happens? this one, this salt, actually this is salt. The salt will undergo neutralization with base. If a salt undergo neutralization by reacting with a base, then that salt is said to be acidic salt, because that salt is having hydrogens which can be removed in the form of H plus ion. So now this H plus ion is, this hydrogen is removed as H plus ion, and it will combine with OH from the base and forms water. It forms a water, and what is left over here? So NaSO4 is left over, and one Na is coming from this one, and it forms Na2SO4. So like this, that means this is the acidic salt. If it is acidic salt, it can react with one more base molecule. Okay, or else it may react with base molecules and form salt. So now this salt is not acidic salt. It is normal salt, because it is not having any hydrogens in it, any replaceable hydrogens in it. Okay, so this is one salt and this is another salt. So like this. So that means the same thing, it can be represented in this fashion also. That means sulfuric acid, when reacted with base, it may form acidic salt, or else the sulfuric acid, when reacted with base, it may form normal salt. It may form normal salt. Normal salt does not have any replaceable hydrogens. If any replaceable hydrogens are there in an acid, then that hydrogen will be replaced by metal atom. So sometimes the acid may form this type of salt, normal salt. Sometimes this acid may form this salt also, acidic salt. Okay, so that means this sulfuric acid has ability to form two series of salts. One is acidic salt and another one is normal salts. So like that, we can discuss about dibasic acids. That means dibasic acids forms two series of salts when reacted with the bases. So in this way, we can discuss about the dibasic acids. Okay, dibasic acids, it forms two series of salts. One is normal salt, another one is acidic salt. Okay, so acidic salt, this particular acidic salt is having one replaceable hydrogen. Hence, that acidic salt, it may react with one more base. It may react with base further, and finally this will convert into normal salt. So even this reaction is also said to be neutralization reaction, because this is showing acidic behavior. So formation of water, what is neutralization? Neutralization is nothing but formation of water and salt from base and acid. So here it is salt, though it is salt, it is behaving as acid, because it is still having one replaceable hydrogen. That means that hydrogen can be replaced by metal. This salt can replace its hydrogen by another metal, and this hydrogen will be lost in the form of water molecule. Okay, so such salts are said to be acidic salts. Right. Now we learn about the dibasic acids. So some examples of dibasic acids we will see. See some examples. H2SO4, H2CO3, oxalic acid. What is oxalic acid? What is the formula of oxalic acid? This is called as carbonic acid. H2CO3, carbonic acid. Okay, so oxalic acid. Oxalic acid means COOH. Two COOH groups are there. So every COOH group can produce one H plus ion. So as there are two COOH groups, hence it can produce two H plus ions. That is why it is said to be one molecule of oxalic acid can produce two H plus ions. Hence this oxalic acid is said to be dibasic acid. Or else I may write like this, the same thing like this. COOH taken twice. Or else like this also I can write H2C2O4. 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 Oxalic acid. Okay. Some more examples like H2S, H3PO3. So this is hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide is also shows acidic behavior. Rotten egg smell gas, already we learnt about this one. It also shows acidic behavior. Dibasic acid. So it is a phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid. See, if you see the structures of these acids, look here, sulfuric acid. Sulfur is the central atom. So it forms, it combines with four oxygen atoms like this. Every oxygen will form two bonds. Every oxygen will form two bonds. So these two hydrogens are attached to oxygen. Okay, like this. Sulfur is attached to four oxygens. Okay, see, remember one thing. Suppose these are the, if the central atom is non-metal, if the central atom is non-metal and that non-metal, it is connected to hydrogen through oxygen. If a non-metal is connected to a hydrogen through oxygen, then this bond will become weak bond. This bond will break easily in water. So in the presence of water, this bond will break easily and forms a H plus and minus. So here also the same type of structure, H plus minus. So what happens? So this entire unit, one sulfur and four oxygens with two negative charges. One negative charge and another negative charge. Okay, and two H plus ions it produces. It produces two H plus ions. So that means one molecule of this compound, it is able to produce two H plus ions. Hence it is a dibasic acid. If you see the structure of carbonic acid, even carbonic acid, it will be like this. Carbon, again it is a non-metal. When a non-metal is connected to hydrogen through oxygen, so here the bond between oxygen and hydrogen, it will break in the presence of water. So what happens in the presence of water, even this bond also will break and produce H plus ion and O minus. H plus ion and O minus. Hence what happens? Carbon along with the three oxygens and minus two. So this is called as carbonate ion, and two hydrogens are produced, two H plus ions. So that means this particular carbonic acid will break down into ions like this, ionization. In the presence of water only it takes place like this. So even this also, in the presence of water, it will break down and forms like this. So one molecule of this one is producing two H plus ions. Hence it is said to be dibasic acid. Even oxalic acid also. If you see the structure of oxalic acid, so it will be like this. COOH. But already we know that carbon will form four bonds. So how many bonds are there? 1, 2, 3 bonds are only present. So that means between these two carbon there will be one more bond. Okay. Now if you see, this is a non-metal carbon. non metal is connected to hydrogen through oxygen. So that what happens, so in the presence of water, so this bond will become weak bond and it breaks down into H plus and here O minus. Here also it will break down into H plus, it will break down and O minus. So two H plus ions are produced. And what is this one? So C2, two carbons, okay, four oxygens. C2, O4, minus 2. And two H plus ions are produced. So this is called as oxalate ion. Oxalate ion. So this is oxalic acid. It is oxalic acid. Oxalic acid will produce oxalate ion and two H plus ions. So one molecule of this acid is producing two H plus ions. Hence it is dibasic acid. So here it is carbonic acid. It produces carbonate ion. This is sulfuric acid. It produces sulfate ion. So this is called as sulfate ion. This is called as carbonate ion. This is called as oxalate ion. Okay. So if you see H3PO3 structure, let us discuss. H3PO3 phosphorus. OH. See, this is the important thing. So this hydrogen is directly connected to non-metal. But here this hydrogen is connected to non-metal through oxygen. Here this hydrogen is also connected to non-metal through oxygen. So in that case, the bond between oxygen and hydrogen, it breaks down and produces H plus and O minus. Here also it breaks down and produces H plus and O minus. But this hydrogen, it does not become into H plus ion. Okay, so because the phosphorus here, the central atom and hydrogen, this bond will be strong bond and it cannot break. Okay, so as a result of this, what happens? It forms, so this entire thing will behave as a unit. This entire thing will behave as a single unit and it forms HPO3 minus and two hydrogens, two H plus ions are producing. So in this way, phosphorus acid will produce two H plus ions. One mole of phosphorus acid, it is producing two H plus ions. And this is said to be dibasic acid. Though it is having three hydrogens in it, but one of the hydrogen is a not replaceable hydrogen. So it cannot be ionized into H plus ion. Only ionizable hydrogens will be called as replaceable hydrogens. So this is ionizable hydrogen. This is ionizable hydrogen. Hence replaceables. So these two hydrogens are replaceable hydrogens. Okay, but this is not a replaceable hydrogen because it is a non-ionizable hydrogen. So it remains in the anion only. Okay, it does not come out in the form of H plus ion from that part. So this particular acid, after losing these two H plus ions, okay, this acid molecule will appear like this. And even this acid molecules also, this acid molecule, after losing these two H plus ions, so this acid molecule will convert into this one. So like this, so these are some of the examples of dibasic acid. Okay, so in the same way, let us learn one more acid, H2SO3. H2SO3 sulfurous acid. H2SO3, this is sulfuric acid, this is sulfurous acid. So if you observe properly, so the structure of sulfurous acid will be like this. The structure of sulfurous acid will be like this. So these two are weak bonds, they can be broken. Only in the presence of water these bonds will break down and produce H plus ion, O minus H plus ion. So it forms SO3 minus 2 minus, okay, minus 2, okay, plus, plus what? Plus 2 H plus ions, plus 2 H plus ions. So as one molecule of this one is producing only 2 H plus ions, okay, hence this molecule is said to be, this acid molecule is said to be dibasic acid. Okay, so like this. So sulfurous acid is also dibasic acid, as one molecule of this one can produce 2 H plus ions upon ionization in water. Okay, so like this, the discussion with about dibasic acids will be. Okay, right. Now we will discuss about tribasic acids. Tribasic acids. What are tribasic acids? Tribasic acids. So the acids whose basicity is 3. Basicity is 3. That means one molecule. That means one molecule of this acid. One molecule of acid, okay, produces or else gives, produces or gives 3 H plus ions, 3 H plus ions on complete ionization, on complete ionization. Okay, so if one molecule of acid can produce 3 H plus ions on complete ionization, then such a acid molecules are said to be tribasic acid molecules. Okay, that means tribasic acids. Such acids are said to be tribasic acids. Okay, see, like how dibasic acids, we have discussed about dibasic acids. Even tribasic acids also, these tribasic acids, they ionize in 3 steps. They ionize in 3 steps. Okay, undergo ionization in 3 steps. Tribasic acids undergo ionization in 3 steps. How do they undergo? What are those 3 steps? See, for example, take phosphoric acid. Example, phosphoric acid. H3PO4 here. O4. Not phosphorus. It is phosphoric acid. Not phosphorus acid. So it is phosphoric acid. What happens? This phosphoric acid in the presence of water. So, it may lose one H plus ion and form H2PO4 minus and H plus ion. That means this H plus ion will convert into H3O plus. Okay, so instead of writing H plus ion, I am writing H3O plus, because H plus ion always convert into H3O plus ion in water. So this is one step, first step ionization. In the first step ionization, it loses one H plus ion and converts into H2PO4 minus. Okay, H2PO4 minus. Next, again this one, this is H2PO4 minus. In the presence of water, again it loses one more hydrogen and forms HPO4 minus 2, and one more H plus is lost in the form of H3O plus. So this is a second step ionization. This is the second step of ionization. Okay, so this is formed. So this is called as dihydrogen phosphate ion It is called as hydrogen phosphate ion. Okay. It is called as hydrogen phosphate ion, or else monohydrogen phosphate ion. We can also call it as monohydrogen phosphate ion. Whereas this is dihydrogen phosphate ion. This monohydrogen phosphate ion, this monohydrogen phosphate ion, it may lose one more H plus ion because it contains one hydrogen extra. See this phosphorus acid, it will be like this. Just see the structure of phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid. Sorry, phosphoric. It is phosphoric acid. So phosphoric acid, it has this structure. So that means in the presence of water, so this bond can be broken. First it will, one bond will break and forms what? Minus and H plus. So this is formed. And this one will again will lose one H plus. That means this one will again lose one H plus and forms, okay, and forms PO4 minus 2, HPO4 minus 2 and H plus. And even this hydrogen also will be lost from this one. So this will lose one more hydrogen in the presence of water and forms PO4, sorry, PO4 minus 3 plus H3O plus. So this is the third step. Third step. That means this phosphoric acid, it will lose these three hydrogens. Okay, so stepwise. So that means this phosphoric acid will undergo ionization in three steps. So like this, step one, step two, step three. So in this way, tribasic acid will undergo ionization in three steps. Tribasic acid will undergo ionization in three steps. Right. What is the next point about this tribasic acids? The next point is, it can form three series of salts. Dibasic acid will form two series of salts, whereas a tribasic acid will form three series of salts. Okay. It can form three series of salts. It forms three series of salts. Three series of salts. Whenever three series of salts are there, so two series of salts will be acidic salts and one series of salt will be normal salt. What are they? Acidic salt, one type of acidic salt one. Another type of acidic salt, known as acidic salt 2. So second type of acidic salt and normal salt. And normal salt. So three series of salts it forms. How it forms three series of salts we will learn now. The tribasic acid forms three series of salts. So first one, with bases, three series of salts when reacted with bases, when reacted with bases. Okay, so you will see H3PO4 when reacts with the NaOH, this is a base, this is an acid. So what happens? It undergo acid-base reaction, neutralization reaction. So here, one OH from base, it will combine with only one hydrogen, only with one hydrogen from this acid. So forms H2O. Okay. So now, that hydrogen, one of the hydrogen is lost from this one. That hydrogen is replaced by sodium and forms NaHPO4 monohydrogen monosodium phosphate, hydrogen phosphate. The name of this one is sodium, here it should be two hydrogens. The name of this one is sodium dihydrogen phosphate. Sodium dihydrogen phosphate. So this is a salt. This is a salt. Okay, phosphate salt. Okay, and this is water. So if you see, observe the salt. The salt is having still two more replaceable hydrogens. Okay, this, hence it is a salt of one type. Okay, next. Okay, so a salt with two replaceable hydrogen. So in this process, what is the result? A salt with two replaceable hydrogens. Okay, salt with two replaceable hydrogens. Two replaceable hydrogen H plus ions. Two replaceable H plus. Okay. Is formed. So the same acid, it may form like this. H3PO4. It may react with two moles of two NaOH molecules. So what happens? So here how many OH are there? Two OHs are there. From base, two molecules of base are there. Hence, it produces two OH ions. Hence, this molecule will lose two H plus ions. Okay. So, two H plus ions from here and two OH minus ions from here. Hence, it forms two water molecules. And what is left over here? Two sodium ions are left over here. And here HPO4 is left here, hence this two sodium ions and HPO4 minus, so they combine, so it forms Na2HPO4. That means here there should be three hydrogen atoms with phosphate, but due to reaction with base, only one hydrogen is left over. That means two hydrogens are replaced by two sodium atoms. Okay. There is only one replaceable hydrogen left over. So now it is also a salt. The name of this one is a disodium hydrogen phosphate. Disodium hydrogen phosphate. Disodium hydrogen phosphate. Salt, it is also salt. Okay, so this salt is different from this salt. This is one salt, this is another salt, because here only one sodium is there, but here there are two sodium atoms. So these two are acidic salts because it is having replaceable hydrogens. Even this is also having replaceable hydrogens. So this is acidic salt and even this is also acidic salt. So tribasic acid will form three series of salts. So out of three series of salts, one series of salt is acidic salt, another series of salt is also acidic salt only. Like this. The same phosphoric acid, suppose it may react with base in this fashion also. H3PO4 plus NaOH, it may react with the three moles of base, that means three molecules of base. So three OH minus ions will come from this base and three H plus ions, okay, will replace these three, combine with the three OH and forms three water molecules, and these three sodiums will combine this with the phosphate. So because this has lost three hydrogens, so instead of three hydrogens, these three sodiums are replaced. Okay,
That means it forms Na3 PO4. So this is a salt, sodium phosphate. It is called as sodium phosphate salt. Okay, so there are no hydrogens here in this salt, hence no need of mentioning hydrogen like this. So if hydrogens are there, then the name will be like this. It will be lengthy. So hydrogens are not there. It is a normal salt. Okay, how this is a normal salt. So normal salt, how do you name the normal salt? Normal salt simply can be mentioned by mentioning the name of the metal and the name of the anion present in it. So here anion is phosphate and the name of the metal is sodium. So normal salt will be mentioned like this. But acidic salts, so they are due to the presence of hydrogens. So how many hydrogens are there in that salt we have to mention. Suppose if there are two hydrogens, we have to mention it as dihydrogen. If there is only one hydrogen, we have to simply mention it as hydrogen. So how many metal atoms are there, we have to mention along with that. So for acidic salts, the name will be somewhat lengthy. But for normal salts, simply the name will be very simple. Okay, here, this particular salt, that means, here a salt with one replaceable H plus is formed. Okay, so in this reaction, a salt with one replaceable H plus is formed. This salt is having one replaceable H. In this reaction, a salt with two replaceable hydrogens, a salt with two replaceable H plus ions is formed. Hence, this is acidic salt. This is also acidic salt because still they are having replaceable hydrogens. So when replaceable hydrogens are there, so that salts can react with bases. Even this salt also can react with base, but this salt, so there are no replaceable hydrogens, so it is said to be normal salt. Okay, neutral salt, it cannot react with base. These are acidic salts, they can react with base. This is a neutral salt, it cannot react with base. So in this way, this is salt with no replaceable hydrogen. Okay. A salt with no replaceable H plus ions is formed. So what type of salt is formed here? So here if phosphoric acid reacts with base completely with three molecules of base. So here the salt which is formed, it is not having any replaceable hydrogen. So such salts, that means a salt with no replaceable hydrogen is formed. Okay, so a salt which is having no replaceable hydrogen, such salt is formed. Okay, so this is the third series of salt. So three series of salts, a tribasic acid can form three series of salts. So after three series of salts, one series of salt is acidic salt, another series of salt is also acidic salt, but the third series of salt is normal salt. So like this, the discussion about tribasic acids will be, right. So now, in the next class, we'll discuss the classification of acids based on the strength. Based on the strength of the acids, we'll discuss about the classification of acids. Right.